Oh, it's question time, Gary. We've had a question in from Andrew in Cambridge, who's been having a spot of bother with bell transformers in a doorbell installation.
Okay, so we're talking about where the transformer is built within the consumer unit and the problem being where we've got band one and band two voltages present.
Yeah, and I think it's mainly the cabling that's caused the problem there. I mean, here's the typical installation we've got. Yeah, obviously the bell transformer in there, and obviously these days a lot of people are having to either change them or go back to installations because people are fitting smart doorbells, a bit like this Natatmo one that we fitted on our smart home takeover.
Absolutely, and you've got obviously that extra low voltage is 0 to 50 volts AC, and then we've got our band 2, which is called low voltage, which is 51 to 1000 volts AC, and there's an issue where the two come together, Gordon.
Yeah, so what is that issue, Gary?
Well, you don't want the voltage from effectively the band 2 appearing in the band 1 because the insulation around the band 1 conductors is not as a higher value as those at band 2.
Okay, so what's the solution we've got here, Gary?
Well, there's a couple of solutions. Shall we cut to those?
Let's have a look, yeah. So this is the problem that Andrew was facing on site. You can see that bell wire twisting its way around all of the other cables in the consumer unit, Gary.
Yeah, and we've obviously got the two different voltages that we've discussed as well, and that becomes an issue, doesn't it? Because we don't want the voltage from the mains cables to appear in that one that's actually at 8 volts.
So what's one possible solution?
Yeah, one possible solution is to oversleeve it in a material that is rated at the same value of rating as the mains voltage in there, so in other words, the band 2 value of voltage within the consumer unit. That is very difficult to put on because the bell wire is incredibly supple, one would suggest.
Yeah, they don't seem to supply thick bell wire anymore.
So we oversheath it. So the insulating material around the conductors was only rated up to 50 volts AC. So now by adding that on, we get the higher value of voltage insulation around it. Yeah, so straightforward.
Yeah, so you're putting that back through the whole... Yeah, obviously, we don't know what's happening behind the scenes there, do we? That bell wire could be twisting its way around all those cables behind the scene, but at least there's an additional sheath on top of those.
Yeah, and when we put the cover on the top of the bell transformer, you'll see that you'll see none of the, 8 volts that it's rated at, isn't it? The transformer itself on the outgoing side. So we'll see it there. You just see the 8 volts on it. Yeah.
Now, we faced this problem on the our smart home takeover. We fitted a smart doorbell there. And that has, they've used a security alarm wire for the bell circuit. And again, that's only rated to 50 volts, so that's something we'll look to correct.
Yeah, when we return to that installation, change the board. So that already looks tidier. We've routed it better, and we'll obviously oversleeved it. This is one of my favourite ways of doing it, is just use mains rated value cable. So in other words, I've used 1 mil twin and CPC here.
Yeah, twin and earth, if you're listening from the real world. that looks good, Gary. I think you might struggle at the other end there where you bring that into the chime itself, because the terminals tend to be very small, and so do the cable entries. Well, it was just sensible solutions there, Gary. I've got a third one for you.
Okay, go on then, you do your third one.
Don't put the bell transformer in a consumer unit.
Okay, yeah, so it'll be perhaps nearer to the actual bell chime itself or built within it.
Yeah, you can get built-in ones, yeah.
I've got a question for you then.
Okay.
Let's presume that Amendment 2 of the 18th edition wiring regulation comes in as it's proposed to be done. Mm-hmm. Okay, and that was proposing that we'd have an AFDD on final circuits up to and including 32 amps. So wouldn't that mean that an AFDD would have to be on your final circuit then?
Yeah, it would do. If it was a dedicated circuit, then yes, it would. And obviously, we did one in here and we had that debate, didn't we? Is it a bit overkill to put an AFDD right next to the transformer? And there's probably, 3 inches of wire between them to arc fault protect against. So, yeah, it's a good point. So, what would my solution be there? I would be... just putting the bell on the lighting circuit.
Absolutely, and also we left a gap, didn't we? This bell transformer here isn't made by Wilex, so there's another question for everyone. It'll probably pose another question, won't it? Yeah. Can you introduce a transformer not specified or from the manufacturer itself into that consumer unit? Type test and all that sort of stuff comes into play.
Yeah, you're right, Gary, because obviously the problem we see in a lot of installations is the existing bell transformer needs to be changed when you put a smart doorbell in, depending upon the manufacturer of the smart doorbell. We didn't, luckily, but when we go back to site as well, we've got that problem with the cabling because someone wired the circuit in security wire, which is only rated at 50 volts. So perhaps you'll tune back in when we do that board change on that project.
Again, we think we've answered Andrew's question. So two solutions that I came up with was obviously the oversleeving at the voltage band of band 2, okay, or to wire it in thermoplastic PVC cables. That's fine. Your solution was to take it and put it obviously remote to the board, and we then threw up another scenario. Also, we've thrown up the scenario about the actual transformer itself. So we always like these questions. And if you're an expert on it, please leave those comments and questions below and help other people out in the chat. We also are interested in your thoughts on this. Is there another way? Have we come up with a fourth solution to the problem that we didn't think about? If you have, put that in the comments below and it will help everyone within our community. Yeah. We'll try and get back to as well.
Well, yes, as many as we can.
We will.
But if you have another regulations-related question, Gary would be delighted to answer it
Absolutely,
for you.
And I will pass it on to Joe, no problem.